The Philippine Coast Guard slams what it called China's use of brute force to assert its illegal claims in Philippine waters. See, on Tuesday, China once again fired water cannons on Philippine vessels on a resupply mission near Scarborough Shoal. The attack lasted for nearly an hour, causing damage to the PCG's BRP Bagakay and a vessel of the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources. Chinese vessels also shadowed the Philippine convoy, carrying out dangerous maneuvers.
Comparing the size of the China Coast Guard vessels and the Philippine Coast Guard vessel, wherein it's only a 44-meter vessel, and this is what they're doing, it just completely shows how China Coast Guard uses brute force to bully their way around to justify their illegal claim in Bajo de Masinloc. All of this railing ay mga bakal. So you can just imagine how high the pressure that was used against the Philippine Coast Guard vessel, kasi nagkabali-baliko ang railing ng Coast Guard vessel. And then on the part of the BFAR vessel, nasira nila yung communication antenna nila.
Commodore Jay Tariela of the PCG also refutes China's claims it was able to stop the mission.
Our BFAR, despite of the damage that we sustained, and the Philippine Coast Guard vessel remains to be within the vicinity of Bajo de Masinloc. We're still giving away fuel subsidies to our Filipino fishermen, food packs, and also even water for them to sustain their fishing expedition in Bajo de Masinloc. The Chinese government used a total of 9 maritime forces, 4 China Coast Guard vessels that physically harassed the Philippine Coast Guard vessels, and 4 Chinese maritime militia that we also physically monitored that supported the China Coast Guard from preventing the Philippine Coast Guard and BFAR vessel in reaching Bajo de Masinloc. And from a certain distance, without a direct participation of harassment, we monitored the People's Liberation Army Navy.
And let's now get an update on the Philippine resupply mission near Scarborough Shoal. We're joined by our correspondent, John Banahan. John, what more can you tell us?
Carmina, good noon. As you can see on my background, the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources ship is still handing out food and fuel supplies to several fishermen here in the waters of Zambales and those coming from the Scarborough Shoal. Because of the latest incident from the Chinese ships yesterday, however, Filipino fishermen had to come to the BFAR ship here in the waters in Zambales, where it is safe for all of us. Filipino fishermen lined up for the food and fuel supply as early as 5 p.m. yesterday. Videos we took showed how the mission did not stop the whole night and is still ongoing. This after the Chinese Coast Guard fired water cannons at both sides of the Philippine Coast Guard and Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources vessels. We also got information that some radar equipment from the BFAR ship were also destroyed. The ordeal lasted for at least 3 hours, destroying our ship's canopy and railings. The water cannon blasts were also recorded through a drone shot taken by the Philippine Coast Guard. No one was hurt from the incident. Before this, around 7 a.m. at the vicinity of the Bajo de Masinloc, a couple of Chinese Coast Guard ships watched us from afar. Then came the chase and dangerous maneuvers to block the PCG's pathway. The armed forces of the Philippines earlier said it was ready to support Filipino missions in the West Philippine Sea when necessary. The AFP, however, said there was no guidance to mobilize following the incident, but noted the move should be very calculated amid the tensions in the waterway. I just want to show you, Carmina, the extent of the damage on our ship. This canopy was destroyed. And you can see that some of its pipes were broken or bent. Now, right now, Carmina, we are still seeing a couple of Chinese Coast Guard ships around the area, but they are very far from us. Carmina.
All right, thanks a lot. Our very own Job Banahan there joining us live.